Well, hello. I'm gonna show you guys my 100-hour Vintage Story World Year 2. Right now we are in the starter house. You can tell because there's crap everywhere. And it's not built with like good materials, as you can see. But it's okay, I guess. We can't go without some jams, you know? This is, as you can see, a modded world. Just from this. This is the starter village of Loot. That's what it looks like on the map. Pretty good. But a lot of foliage everywhere. And there's stone paths connecting everything I've built so far. Just a basic wall on the outside. Some needlessly complicated stairs. This here is food storage, but, you know, I have moved out of the starter town. Got my plants. And since it is winter, you know, not too much going on. This here is for cooking. Just got a little loft up here. Here's where I grew everything. I believe it's all still Terrafreda? Yeah, I didn't know. Terrafreda. This was for charcoal. Here's mainly for bricks. Not too much, because, you know, starter area. This is how I did all my smithing and stuff. Extended workbench. This is its own mod. You can put in something that you've chiseled here. And your chisel and the blocks for it, and it'll auto-chisel it for you with durability. Super useful. Storage, never needed more chests than this for the starter area, it's not too bad. I think this is, yeah, this is just stone that I haven't emptied yet, because why would I? This is for glass. And that is the entire starter village. Loot. Not too bad. But I have connected everything with that. I might have said that, I don't remember. It took a while. There's a path going here, all the way to a not that naturally generated structure. But I'm not gonna go there because it's naturally generated. It's hard to tell where the path is because of the snow. But I can see it. Ergen? I don't know. I made up the word myself. I haven't decided how to pronounce it. But that's okay. It's a new generation, but it's fine. There's a separate path here that's not normal stuff, because it's just a side path. And here, into this little, like, cottage area. Got a tiny dock. Some remarkably large chairs. Nothing on the table for some reason. My brick collection. I don't know where I got all these from, but... No books. No books. Yeah. It's a nice building. I like it. Not complex at all, though. We can go back. Oh, and I'm pretty sure my walk speed is like slightly higher than normal. I don't remember, it's been a while since I made the world, since, you know, 100 hours. This here is the loot mine. It is a massive quarry that gets even bigger over there, but I'm not going to show you because Drifters was small. So I'm just going to leave. On to Ergen. And I was planning on making Ergen like a normal-sized city, but at this point it's going to be big enough to be a cavern. Even though I haven't put that much in there, I have my plans, and they're pretty big. I estimate it'll take, like, at least 200 hours to finish it. Like, 200 more hours to finish the town. You can see it already. That's going to be a second windmill since we've got the one. And all of these trees here, it looks like a forest, but really this is just from all the oak that I need. And there's some other trees too, but it's mainly oak. There's a few walnut, and maybe there should be purple heart around here too. And this here, there's gonna be a bridge here. Working drawbridge from a mod, I don't remember which one, but it's very cool. Maybe it's the medieval one. But you can tell it's not vanilla because it flashes a little bit once it opens or closes. Still super cool though. Got some more custom chisel stuff. And if you're wondering what's back here, nothing. Haven't built it yet. The wall is massive, what I have so far, based on the amount of blocks, but, you know, that's okay. See, the amount of blocks needed to make that are huge, because, you know what these are made out of? Yeah. Just a huge pain. Not to mention mortar, but mortar isn't a big issue for me anymore. This is awesome, it actually warms you up. And I've got another one of those over there. Storage. This was the first house I made here. A stereotypical starter house, except, you know, it's not a starter house anymore, it's just the first house in this village. It's definitely not a village, it's a town. And I've got both beds, for depending on how long you want to sleep. I don't have an old ruined bed, or whatever it's called yet. I will get one soon, though. Let's see, what should we have next? Yes! Perfect. This instrument mod is awesome, too, by the way. Teleporter, I'll show it for you. And normally I just do TVWPER, it's super simple. Just instantly. You don't even have to like move your left hand at all. But I really like my the snow's just stuck on there. My picnic tables. Very fun. That's why I have so many of them. This took a while to make. It's not perfect, but it looks pretty nice at least. Obviously, this would not function well in real life. You'd have to be 18 feet tall or something to make it reasonable, but no. And I've got 4 of these plots, which is more than enough food for one person, as you might expect, but 2 of them are always flanks, so. And here is the food storage. Oops. No, yeah, we'll just do it for me to the I have a lot of food. And there's more down here, but I'll have to put a bunch of chests. It'll be a lot. I don't have enough food yet for it to matter. And more picnic tables. And for each of the picnic tables, it's like this with the shell cobblestone. But as you can tell, it's snowing. It only started snowing like 2 days ago though, so not bad at all. Since I'm not actually that high up, despite the fact that I'm building on a mountain, or rather building in a mountain, as you can see, especially down there, so much mining. Like, it probably doubles the time it takes to build something. That's okay. This is gonna be the next windmill. But this is just gonna be for corn ends, so I'll have, yeah, 2 corns, one and one. This will just be the door. See, I already have the structure for it, but I don't have the resources, especially not the flax. Because you need a lot of flax to make a proper windmill. But this entire section here is gonna be like the industrial stuff, and then over there it'll be like housing and stuff. This here is my the tanning area. Or mainly for leather, but also like mortar and anything else you need barrels for. And leather is very important for backpacks. And the alcohol is the same as you keep doing. Okay. But also, you can make all sorts of things with it. And the reason why I only have three backpacks is because a glider will take up the backpack, so the only thing preventing me from making it is this, which is found in the big structure. I don't remember what it's called. But that's okay. And everywhere you look, there is some type of chisel thing. Is it very detailed? No. It's more detailed than it needs to be. Now this is a very detailed one. This might not be able to tell. That's just a structure. I don't have anything there yet. But this is just more housing. Kitchen, let's see, let's do something that won't sound terrible for this one. Yes. It was fun to make the countertops. It doesn't look the best with the ovens on top, but that's too bad. Well, I'm gonna starve. Looks like this song's gonna stop. There's that. But yeah, I'm 100 hours in, and there's far less buildings there than there could be because of the amount of detail I'm putting into them. Ooh, this hurts my ears, no thank you. That's hilarious. I've got a table, benches, chairs. It works. Generic desk, books. And the way I made these is with, why am I doing that? With this mod, the colored blocks mod. Very useful, I highly recommend it. I need to put stuff on top of these, but, I will. Who's outside? Clothesline. It doesn't look as good with the snow, but I'm proud of this. Similar desk. Books. Actual bookshelves are, expensive. So instead, I chiseled it. It took way more time than I needed to, and, we have this. Oh, I haven't named this one yet. This is a big bedroom. It's for those, fun times that we need to have at night. It's got hospital quarters, because I just didn't feel like adding white marble. You're welcome. Technically, it doesn't. I mean, you can't see the fold here, but it's whatever. Up here, you've got a storage area that only has a dresser so far. And you got another room here. And that is this building. I still need to put, two or three lanterns in there and stuff, but... pretty good. And the roof, is actually remarkable the way it works because of all the different weirdly shaped building, the way I made it. It all fits together, it's just strange. And it would be better if we looked at it from the top, but here. Since this is still just a structure, we can actually get up there. Yeah, because we've got that, and this, and this, and that, it just keeps going, it's a lot. But this is the biggest building I have so far in this world, and also the last one that I've yet to show. It's a blacksmith with a shop front. That's one enter in the shop. And this room alone took me like 10 hours at least, just of chiseling these things. Each one, apart from the box, is a reference. You get all of them, we have similar tastes, and you need to go outside. This one is a one-for-one pixel recreation, at the very least. And all of the names are slightly off, too. These ones aren't that hard to tell what this is, because it's from a very popular franchise that honestly isn't that good. But the name is one of my favorites because of how dumb I changed the naming scheme to be. This is not one-to-one pixels, but you might be able to know what it is. Let's see. Yep. And these ones are literally just junk, like no actual references here. And this one isn't as accurate as it could be simply because I ran out of space. It would have needed like another block here to be fully accurate, but it's okay. As a reference, it's still nice. This one is not very hard to tell what it is. This one's name is such a stupid joke. This one is very easily recognizable. It's not hard to recreate. This one you can tell what it is, but the coloring isn't great. I didn't have the color blocks on when I made this, I got it later. Yeah, that's this room. Very fun. Behold, juice. I thought that was funny. And this is intentionally like claustrophobic because you're going back into the employee section. Just the way you have a sudden turn and then bump, bump. Yeah. Very realistic. 10 out of 10. Just, of course, my smithing area now. It has actually a lot of space for storage, which is great. I'm gonna change this into an angle once I get the cornfield building set up properly, but for now I just have this. And then more storage for extra things. Nothing in here yet. You can just come out. I'm thinking about maybe keeping this as shale rock, just to show like a really solid foundation for this massive building. But I might not. I haven't decided yet. In this wall, there's this hole here, because it's going to go down into the ground and be more storage. If I'm actually going to store anything, I don't know, but it's going to look like storage at least. Cool. Yeah. Beautiful. But it's definitely my biggest building. Very fun. That doesn't go up very tall, especially not in comparison to that. It's okay. I had to mine so much for this, dude. It's crazy. I actually need all that stone for the path, because all of the stone path is... That's not a button. Four stones and a dirt for one stone path, which doesn't seem like a bad deal, but you get like maybe three per block. And dirt is something I've come to hoard. Like every block of dirt you see here... Yeah, see that? That's how I make the most use out of my dirt. It's with that. It's, it works, you know? It works very well. But that is everything I have in my 100 hours so far. I might do this again for 200 hours? I don't really know. But, that's what I got. That's all, folks. This is Eragonia. I'll see you next time I decide to make some sort of video, because I do that like every 6 months or something. Later.